I think it would be pretty extraordinary. And, you know, we are getting kind of ahead of ourselves here in thinking about Kim Jong-un making a visit to the White House. It certainly wouldn't be a state visit, I'll tell you that. It would just be a leader visit here to the White House. But the Secretary of State here, I mean, obviously realistic about the chances of success here and very serious, absolutely serious about the issues are at stake, but very optimistic about the potential road forward here, revealing that in his two meetings that he's had with Kim Jong-un face-to-face in Pyongyang, he was told directly, personally, by the leader of North Korea that he is willing to dismantle his nuclear program. Kim Jong-un telling the Secretary of State Mike Pompeo that we have to do it differently than it's been done in the past. It has to be, quote, big, and it needs to be bold. But the Secretary of State reiterating, Neil, that the only way to move forward here is with the complete, irreversible, and verifiable denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula. He did say that they have narrowed, I think you mentioned this at the top, the definition of what denuclearization means, though when he was pressed to give us some level of detail, he deferred and said, I won't talk to you about that right now. But this is something that will come out over time. The president suggesting again today, as he has in the past, that this likely won't get completed in one meeting, though he hopes that in one meeting will certainly put the United States and North Korea on a path to the eventual denuclearization. And the president even said this afternoon, maybe the normalization of relations between the United States and North Korea after all this time, and maybe even an agreement to end the Korean War. The president said that they might sign something on Tuesday in Singapore, though it likely wouldn't be an actual peace deal. That would probably take some months to craft. Neil?
You mentioned the meeting on the 12th, and I'm wondering, is there any possibility this goes beyond that? In other words, that this, well, of course, Reykjavik, and, you know, at the time of Ronald Reagan and Mikhail Gorbachev, that went on for close to a week, but that was pre-planned that way. And, of course, Ronald Reagan walked away from those talks initially. But is there any sense that you're getting, John, from the White House that this could go on longer if talks are promising?
Well, I haven't gotten any sense from the White House that this could go on longer than it's planned, and it's only planned for a day.
Right.
But the one thing that I have come to learn over the last 16 months, 17 months of covering this president is that anything can happen. Last Friday, we were told that Kim Jong-chol, the vice chairman of North Korea, was going to walk into the diplomatic reception room. He was going to walk up the colonnade. He was going to go to the Oval Office, deliver the letter to the president, and then leave. Well, he did leave, but it wasn't until an hour and 15 minutes later, and it was a very cordial atmosphere between the president, the secretary of state, and the vice chairman. There was a lot of shaking of hands, a lot of photos that were being taken. The secretary and the president stood there at the end of the walkway and waved as he left. I mean, that was something that we never expected to see happen. So always expect the unexpected. I think if you live by that credo, Neil, you'll be pretty accurate in terms of trying to divine where this White House is going.
Or life in general, right? Thank you very much, my friend. John Roberts.